you're going to see more and more of these. That prevents the rejuvenation of the system because it keeps happening. If it weren't going to happen anymore, I'd say, oh, well, maybe there's a chance to get this thing back to where it was in a few years or decades. But now I don't think there's a timeline.
So if you're thinking this is the new normal, what kind of policies or infrastructure needs to be in place to support this kind of bushfire season? How can this kind of climate catastrophe be better managed?
So there are things we need to do locally and there are things we need to do globally. At the local level, we're going to have to get really good at forest management. We're going to have to structure burns. We're going to have to see what we can do to remove some of the things that are going to burn from areas. We need to train people not to cause the fires, which is oftentimes a big part of the cause of these fires. Camping, wildfire, camping, you know, people starting campfires can be an issue. So frankly, is our electrification systems. We're going to have to do all of that. So humans need to be smarter in preventing it at the local level and in causing it at the local level. At the global level, we have got to zero out our greenhouse gas emissions. To limit the amount of warming that's taking place, because the warmer this atmosphere, the more greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, the warmer the planet is going to be as a whole, and the more of these extreme heat waves we're going to see, and the greater the extreme heat waves are going to be.
All right, Daniel Kreeger, Executive Director and Co-Founder of the Association of Climate Change Officers. Thank you.
Thanks for having me, Sally.